For any one of these speakers, stand up and ask what you want to ask. Phil has a microphone. He'll give it to you. What do you want to ask? Anyone? Okay, back here's one.
I want to know how the standardized test, all the kids having to learn the same thing, doesn't bust a no state-sponsored religion in the Constitution.
Good question. And the answer is yes, that's what it is. Whenever we give up the right, and I wish I had time to get into this, I did an 8-hour teaching on creation out of order. The home is the center of education for the child, not the state. Did you hear what I said? If you send your child to a public hellhole to get an education, they're going to get an education, all right. But not the kind that's going to glorify their God. Any comments?
If I could just say, the gentleman that just spoke, the pastor that just spoke, I am so impressed. Because that man is walking the walk. And you know, ladies and gentlemen, you know, I can do the program on what I did and what I talked about earlier and the Gulf War veterans and whatever, but we are the soldiers, literally, of this country now. Some of us are going to go down. Some of us are going to be in prison. Some of us are going to die. But this room is full of people here who say, I am willing to do that for freedom. And that's why I respect you so much. The mothers that are homeschooling, you know, clap for yourself. You are doing it. But it's the mothers that are homeschooling. It's the fathers that are saying no to the tyranny. They're saying, I am standing up to that so-called jurisdiction and saying, what are you anyway? Not afraid to challenge, like Butch said, the people in the robes behind the benches. I don't mean anyone any harm. I only want to do what is right. But there are those that are doing harm to others in this country. And it's time that we have some guts, we stand up, and oh well, if I go down, then if that's what it takes, it will have been for the right reason. We are serving now for the right reasons. And when we play those service songs, it's because we want to be powered up that we are the soldiers now. And we're doing it for our Heavenly Father, who is so incredibly powerful. We cannot lose sight of that, ladies and gentlemen. He is so powerful, and He is rewarding those that do the truth. And I just want to say to all of you men who are true husbands in your families, I respect you so much. To you men who are the head of the households, doing the right things, oh my goodness, I am so inspired by you. I come here for a selfish reason. I need to see that you all are real. I need to see that you are doing and thinking and feeling the same way that I am. Because I don't want to be alone. I want to know there's a Catherine Albrecht. I want to know that there's a Butch Paul, a Greg Everson. And the Power Hour show is there because we have to support each other. That's why we like to buy from each other. We want to support you all, and we want you to support us. And I just thank you more than you know. This service has been so inspiring. I mean, Melody in the back, if you have not talked to Melody about getting gold, please do it. Have some in your pocket. Have some for your children to have in case of an emergency. And Melody is about the most amazing person you'll ever know to deal with. And please, she is wonderful, those of you who know her. And please do the right thing by your family. Start eating raw fruits and vegetables. You know that's my sermon. Eat raw fruits and vegetables. Get your family healthy because of what's about to come. And don't take the swine flu vaccine. If there's anything I could say, is say no. And tell other people how dangerous it is, because that is going to be the thing that is going to make the difference between health and illness in my life, in my estimation. So do the right thing and do business from each other here. I thank you all very much. You have blessed my weekend more than you know. More than you know.
Wait a minute, Bob. Microphone's coming. Right behind you.
That's oh, lollipop. I'd like to ask Greg here, since you were in the military, and you were also state police, if I understand right, And I'd like to ask you to comment on the oath that all military took, all public servants took, to support the United States Constitution. What's your understanding of how long the expiration date was on those oaths?
There
Would you comment,
none.
Please?
There is none.
Then we're all under that oath, that who has ever served in the military.
That's
then
correct.
Why aren't the majority of them adhering to that promise before God and man and supporting our Constitution actively?
Many of them, I'm afraid, were under the wrong impression that when their service time ended, their obligation to the oath that they had taken ended as well. Clearly, that's not the case. And I can tell you that I've taken that oath 5 different times. I've never been asked to rescind it. It's still in effect. And I am looking at all enemies, foreign and domestic. And I am trying to do my best to make other police officers and servicemen aware of that very thing. They're becoming aware of it. They're saying, that's right, I never thought about that. And I will honor my oath. I will stand for this republic.
For those of you who don't know, Greg Evenson writes for News with Views. I stumbled upon you this last January, and I thank God I did. You wrote an article this last July 29th. I will never forget it. And there was an excerpt in the article that alarmed me, and not much surprises me anymore, regarding the swine flu and the military, implementing the military to help out. And in the article, I know you don't reveal your sources, but I'd like you to elaborate about the metal shackles they're going to put on the wrists with the computer chip. And maybe, Catherine Albrecht, you can add to that comment.
Unfortunately, I believe one among several plans to ensure that the government's edict of mandated vaccinations, and by the way, the state of Oklahoma last week passed through its House just such a law for the state of Oklahoma and its residents that everyone will be vaccinated in the state of Oklahoma. Now, having said that, there are also plans that will ensure that you do not freely travel, nor will you be able to really go anywhere without proof that you have had the vaccination at the point that the government mandates that certain levels of the population take the inoculation. When that happens, I have been told by state troopers across the country that there are plans ready to be implemented that would include roadblocks at choke points, as we call them, major interstate junctions around major cities and so forth, where the greatest number of people can be held until they are either they either prove their vaccination by papers or, in the case of a medical specialist in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, who told me that they had observed a semi-tractor trailer being unloaded at the hospital loading dock, pallets and pallets, scores of cases of metal bracelets that once put on would slip into a place and be either pegged in there with some kind of device to hold it in place, but the band was meant to be permanent. On top is a chip. That chip will include all kinds of information about you and the fact that you have been inoculated. Now, this is one of several plans. It has not yet seen the light of day, but it is there. It's in readiness. You choose the poison. It's either slow homicide or slow suicide. They're either going to kill you with the injection, or if you go up and say, sure, I just want to be able to go wherever I want to go, and you take it, to me, that's virtual suicide, just slow motion suicide. So we've all talked about not getting the vaccination, that's clear, but you may not have a choice. I am told that the plans include buses that will be standing by for people at roadblocks that refuse to take the inoculation. The people will then be escorted to the buses and taken, as I was told, in the state I was in at that time when I was speaking to the troopers, you're going to get a free ride to a nice warm bunk at Fort Riley. Well, it's one of several plans. We can't know until they're implemented, but I assure you that those plans are in place and law enforcement is going to be pulled in. In one of the articles I wrote, I said the law enforcement community will enforce a new world order. There will be many that will not, and that's good news for us. But I believe it's still a majority that will be standing in line saying, get your shot or get on the bus. That's what's coming.
Yeah, I want to add something to that. Those of you who have copies of Spy Chips, if you look in the index in the back of the book and you look up Guantanamo, you'll see that the first military, at least the first U.S. use of Guantanamo as a detention center was not its current use, that actually it was used over a decade ago to house Haitian refugees, that they were taken to Guantanamo, they were interned, and they were all given an RFID wrist bracelet that could not be removed. And in fact, these Haitian refugees were so concerned about these RFID wrist bracelets that had been put on being the mark of the beast that a number of them attempted to chew them off, and they were severely punished. Their circumstances were so terrible that their food was crawling with maggots. Their toilet situation were open latrines crawling with maggots. They lived in utter filth and stench there in Guantanamo in the broiling, burning sun. They were unable to leave, and they all had those bracelets. So I just want to let you know there is a historical precedent. Our country has placed RFID bracelets onto people who have been detained. So it certainly is, you know, I haven't heard anything about truckloads of bracelets or anything like that, but certainly it would be possible, and we know it's been done in the past. The only other thing I'd add, I'm not sure they would be metal. They might be like a Kevlar that could not be cut, kind of a bulletproof type of material. The only reason I say that is that metal wouldn't be good for RFID because it would reflect the signal. But we also saw some plans, which we talked about in Spy Chips, for arm bracelets. This was a patent that we found where you actually would put an armband on people that were in a detention center. You could load the armband with knockout drugs. And then because they're radio frequency based, a guard could aim his little device at someone. It would release the knockout drug into your bracelet, and you would literally fall to the ground unconscious. That was actually even proposed that it's something they could put on airline passengers. So if they got too close to the cockpit, it would set off. So we know that these technologies have been patented. I don't know if that one's in existence. We heard recently a Saudi Arabian inventor, and there was also a story in Germany where they're, again, trying to resurface these ideas. So the technologies are there, and certainly if they get to the point of wanting to deploy them, it could be done.
Okay, let's do two more.
We talk about the RFID chips. Can, if it's in a credit card or a license, can you turn around and wrap it in aluminum foil? Would that foil them?
Good question. The question was whether you can wrap something with RFID in aluminum foil. The answer is yes. There are companies that sell RFID blocking wallets. There are plans, if you don't want to spend $25, $30, $40 for a professionally made wallet, you can actually go online and look up RFID wallet duct tape, and there's actually a schematic there for how you can make your own with some aluminum foil. It does work. The one thing I would say is if it's a credit card, shame on you for wanting to carry it in the first place. I would not be carrying one of those and blocking it and thinking that's the solution. At this point, there is no reason under the sun why anybody in this country should ever be carrying an RFID device anywhere on their person, unless it's that one circumstance of leaving the country and returning. And I want to add one thing to that. If you have to leave the country, we talked about you've got your three ways to get back. You got a passport. You got a passport card, the little driver's license size card, and you've got an enhanced driver's license if you're from one of those border states issuing them. The only one that is quote-unquote safe is the passport. So you definitely want a passport, not a pass card, not an enhanced driver's license. I say that because there was so much objection when they tried to put RFID into the passport. So they got thousands of comments into the State Department. The entire nation rose up and said, we don't want RFID in there. And when they did that, The State Department responded by doing a couple of things. They put a secure version of RFID, to the extent there is one. It has encryption on it. It cannot be scanned by any random passerby, like the ones on the cart. It has shielding fabric, so when you close your passport, if you keep it tightly closed, it can't be read because the shield is in the cover. It has like the equivalent of tin foil in the cover. So if you have a choice between those, you have to leave the country, get yourself a passport. I'm going to add something else, and you'll have to read between the lines as I say this. 10% of the passports is estimated that the chips will fail, just from usual wear and tear, just from normal wear and tear. Some of them even make it out of the factory. They don't work very well yet. So 10% of the passports are expected to have non-functioning chips. So that means if you had a passport and the chip didn't work, that you would still be able to cross the border, you'd still be able to get in and out of the country, and you would in no way be impacted by your microchip in your passport not working. Now, that being said, people who carry a lot of heavy books maybe, and their passport falls in the bottom of a bunch of heavy books and gets banged, kind of as though a hammer were banging on it, that would probably kill a microchip in a passport. So if you want to keep yours functional, I'd advise not banging it. Be very careful with it. It's delicate machinery. And some people have asked me about microwaves. Microwaves are a very effective way to kill RFID tags, but there's a caveat. They also burn up the thing that they're in. So if you were to take something with a microchip and stick it in the microwave, even 3 or 5 seconds, it'll go poof, but it might also go poof into flames. And that's probably not something you want to do to your expensive Calvin Klein sweater, for example.
One more.
My understanding is that one of the first targets for the swine flu vaccine will be the public school kids. How will they carry that out? Do you have any idea?
I'll give an opinion first and let Joyce speak or won't speak on that. The children go to public school now, they have to have vaccination records or they can't go to public school. I have friends who have doctored the records, and good for them. But by law, these probably will become what they call law, that your children have to have the shot before they can go to school. So that could happen as early as this fall. And I would beg you parents, I don't care what it costs, don't let your child do that. Please, if you love your children, keep them home and teach them at home. That is your job. Read Deuteronomy chapter 6 sometime and tell me who's delegated to teach your children other than you.
Thank you. The sad part is that the way it is right now in the public school systems, there is already an executive order that allows the vaccine to be given mandatorily to everybody. And the problem is with a school system is you are not going to know your child has been vaccinated until they bring home the note that says, Mommy, Daddy, I got my vaccine today. Watch for the following symptoms. Now, that's what's going to happen. That's the way they've got it planned already. I've seen some of the materials. So if your child's in public school, I would certainly put on file, and I told one of the people here today, I do not consent for any vaccines to be given to my child, including any flu vaccines or swine flu vaccine. I do not consent. And I would put that on file. I personally would do it in a way, though, that is going to be accepted by, well, I don't want to say the legal profession now. I know that Jim's going to have a different answer here on not having corporate citizens for children, and I think that's important. But the school needs to know that you do not consent for vaccines. It is not a requirement in any state that they have vaccines. It is a requirement that you have a waiver on file. Now, they're going to try to overcome that because I'm telling you, this is going to be mandatory vaccine for anybody and everybody. They're not even, let's say, for instance, they use an egg-based vaccine. They're not going to ask you, do you have any allergies to eggs? Because they don't care right now. So if you have any allergies at all, they have decided there's going to be just a certain amount of people that are going to die from the allergic reaction. They don't have time because there's such an emergency situation to vaccinate them. So you need to be finding out, and we're doing that right now, to find out a way to have a waiver or a form or some information to say that you are not going to participate in this. And I'm not quite sure how it's going to be. Jim, do you have an opinion on that?
Yeah, I have an opinion on that. It's like we talked about earlier. It's like we talked about earlier, folks. They're your children. They are your children. Trust me, guys, if you got a marriage license, get rid of it. Send a notice in demand to the county and the state you were married in. And listen, you don't have to have their permission to expose the truth that you're not required by law to sign a permission slip with government giving them control over your children. All you have to do is send it certified mail, return receipt request, and tell them that you're sending a copy of your marriage certificate or license with the letter, and they can keep it or throw it away, because you are no longer going to recognize the state having any authority over your children. And I agree with Joyce, this is going to happen no matter what. And the only thing you can do at the school is to notify the school that you and your wife are no longer accepting the license as a privilege for marriage, that you've notified them that you've ended that relationship, and give the school principal or the school nurse or even the school teacher an affidavit notice in demand saying that my children will not be vaccinated by anyone at any time, and make certain that the teacher signs for it or that the school principal signs for it. These people have got to be held accountable if they take our children and they inject them with anything other than love.
Let me just say, there's going to have an immediate uprising from the people. The first time you hear that vaccine is out, people need to start making a lot of noise. Not no, but heck no. And whether it's to go to your sheriff, whatever it's to go to your whatever law enforcement agency and say, I am telling you right now, I'm not going to get vaccinated. So you tell me what's going to happen. And I think we need to start finding out. And we need to go talk to our sheriffs now, because believe me, they're being told about this. Military's already been told they're going to get 3 vaccines for the swine flu. They're going to get 3, mandatory 3 in the military. So it's time that we go talk to our law enforcement people and say, I want to know what your plans are, because I'm going to tell you what mine are.
I have some advice on this front as well, 2 different pieces of advice. Number one, most states do have a religious exemption against, most states do. I know my home state does, and I know of a number of other states that do. Whether they want to respect that or not may be a different question, but most states do have a form you can print from the health department in your state. That's probably a good place to start, is fill that out, put it on file with whoever needs to have it on file, or just have it in your file cabinet at home. The other thing is a medic alert bracelet. And I'll tell you this, here's how I know this. My own husband was vaccinated. He took an overseas trip and got every vaccine under the sun. He wound up in the intensive care unit on Christmas, many, many years ago, when I first married him. I spent Christmas Eve in the waiting room in the intensive care unit while my husband had something called Bell's palsy, where half of his body essentially had a stroke. And this was after receiving vaccines, routine vaccines for travel. Now, after that experience, all of the doctors that he has seen have confirmed, and these are mainstream AMA, medical doctors, have confirmed that he is not to receive a vaccine. So anyone else out there who has a concern, a medical concern, an immune system concern, you name your concern, I'm sure you can think of many things that would probably contraindicate your getting a vaccine or your children doing that, you can get a medic alert bracelet that actually says vaccine contraindicated. And if Medic Alert won't do it, get your own made. Go into the pharmacy. There's places you can have those made up, and just stick it on your kid's wrist. And believe me, anybody within the medical community, and Joyce can attest to this, who sees a medical bracelet on someone's wrist is going to look at what it says before they do anything to that person. And believe me, they're not going to want to lose their job or be sued or have who knows what. They're not going to take the time to ask the question. They're going to look at that and go, oh, you go over there. That's okay, Jimmy. You go home. We'll talk to your mommy later. Yeah.
All right. Folks, we're getting ready to close. Y'all stay here a minute. We're going to play. You want to ask one question? Okay, go ahead. One more question. Who was it? Okay. Come up here, please. Okay.
Guys, I am from Soviet Union. I came in the United States in 1992. And I want to tell you something. Like in my, it was 2 nations who were blessed the God the most. It was Russia in Soviet Union because both countries made the God's law the main law of the land. Both countries went down the hill after they went under Talmud. Russia went in 1917 and America went in 1991, 1 year prior I came here. I came as a refugee. All my relatives were killed in Russia. 145 million people were killed. Guess who killed them? Not the government. It was 385 people. Only 10 people were Russians. It was 2% of population who killed one half of the country. And you were not taught history, and you didn't make efforts to learn what happened in another country. Now it's your turn. And here is 2% who is right now in your government is going to kill all of you. And you will kill each other. You will give each other these shots. It's what you will do. And the other part will take each other brothers and sisters in FEMA camps. 2% will kill the country. Think about it. And where is the God? God is not here anymore. Ask God about help. Don't do what they say.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
I know Pastor Butch is about to wrap this up, and I don't know if all of you are feeling as grateful as I am, and I say I know everybody up here on the stage is feeling, but I really want us all to stand up and give this man a hand for bringing us all together. Pastor Butch, thank you so much. We love you.
You know, folks, this guy might be a little hick from West Virginia, but he's one hell of a fine hick from West Virginia. And he's been one hell of a hostess.
I've enjoyed it. Thank you.
No, it's your turn. Go ahead.
Oh, I want to say thank you to all of you. Everybody that put this on, and to Butch and to Greg and all of you. You guys are awesome. And just don't lose faith once you leave here. And keep in touch with each other. We're going to be having a new website to link people up together and in different communities. So keep the faith and know that you are doing the right thing. And fear no man. My Heavenly Father told me I will keep you free of the fear and the night. And He has.
Thank you. And I'm going to be the guy that gives you the last bit of good news. I got some great stuff in my pocket. You all set? We're going to move on?
Oh. We got one more song to play for everybody here. I think Barry's getting ready to play on CD. Kay sings it over there. And they want to hear it, that the folks want to hear it. So if you'd play a song, Barry, I'd appreciate it. Listen to it, folks.
Must have been cold there in my shadow to never have sunlight on your face. You were content to let me shine. That's your way. You always walked a step behind. So I was the one with all the glory, while you were the one with all the strength.
Hug your neighbor. Go ahead and tell me you love him.
Without a name for so long, a beautiful smile to hide.
Go ahead and tell
your
brother and sister you love him. It's okay.
Look at
the heroes and heroines. Look out there, the heroes, heroines. Like look at them, they're all around you.
And I can fly higher than the eagle. Cause you are the wind beneath my wings.
Some of y'all say, hate to see this end.
To go unnoticed.
Maybe next year, we'll see.
But I've got it all here in my heart. I want you to know I know.
Lisa Shaw, you're my hero.
Of course I know it. I
Lynn Hudock, you're my hero.
You.
Phyllis Coley, I think, is left, but if she's here, Phyllis, you're my hero. Each one of the ladies of our church congregation, you all are my heroes.
You're everything.
I want my children to look up
like to be
to Joyce Riley.
And I could fly
to
Jay. Higher than the eagle.
Power our crew. I'm glad my grandchildren
you are the
and my eldest son and Denise, their mother, as their hero. Patrick, you're my hero. You've stuck with me through a lot. Because you love me.
You're
the Hudock girls, Shaw
like
girls, all the many that has that look like you want to represent Christ. No matter what your age, be a hero through Jesus Christ.
You are the wind beneath my
Kay, thank you so much for letting me use the CD. I love you all so much.
All right, folks, that's it. We're going to have a drawing. We're going to close for tonight. You may want to stay around and help Phil unpack his stuff up. Don't run away. He can use some help. Go ahead, Greg, wrap it up.
Oh, boy.